Please welcome to stage Pauline Williams. Pauline Williams!
Hey there! Hello, my name is Pauline, and I got into comedy because I felt natural on a stage. It took a while to get used to not using a pole, though. No, not that pole. I mean, I used to have a partner, he was Polish. Yeah. So I'm from this really little bitty hick town in the Midwest. And it was really hick because we were so hick we actually thought Leave It to Beaver was a documentary. We didn't have any black people in our town, so affirmative action was on our ass all the time. So our city council finally put up a billboard of Bryant Gumbel. You know, that's a real representative of the hood there. He really makes Barack Obama look like 50 Cent. But I did learn some things. You know, like where I'm from, implants are something you get at the dentist. If you want to drive by, you order a cheeseburger from a clown's head. And strippers and studs? Something you get at the hardware store. So, I had an interesting life, too, because, like, when I came out here, I had a few odd jobs. Like, my first great job was answering phones. I had got, $3 a minute for the first minute and $1.95 for every minute thereafter. Yeah, this one gentleman spent about $1,000 to call up and hear me talk dirty. I earned every cent of it, too, because I hate talking to my dad. So I grew up on a religious compound. Yeah. This place made Waco interesting, especially because it was like Waco before the fire. We had an interesting set of values. We couldn't dance, couldn't watch TV, could not go to the movies, but we could own a gun. Yeah, let me see, gun, TV. I think you read every day about somebody being killed by a flat screen, being thrown out of a moving vehicle. Growing up was all about mental abuse, physical abuse, sexual abuse, but hey, I'm sure you're tired of me talking about church. I get asked a lot if I ever want to go back, organize a reunion with my friends. I look at those people who ask me that and say, you ever go up to an Auschwitz survivor and ask them if they want to go back and organize a reunion? So I was married once. I was married just long enough to figure out marriage is a lot like a timeshare. I got sucked in by a great presentation and the promise of a free TV. And nobody told me TV stands for transvestite. Yeah, every girl dreams of growing up and marrying a movie star. I just didn't know mine was Tim Curry in the Rocky Horror Picture Show. There was no sex on our honeymoon night. Yeah, aw. He didn't want to run his hose. Of course, the other hose didn't work very much either. Should have seen the alarm bell when I got the Victoria's Secret bill for $1,000 and knew none of it was in my drawer. Yeah. Interestingly enough, he was a gourmet chef at a 5-star restaurant, so he would never let me cook. No, he'd come home and fix me a packet of instant oatmeal.
Ain't you tired? I've been serving customers all day.
So I got a job in a whorehouse. Came home, fixed him a bottle of lotion. Well, I didn't want to run my hose. Yeah. So, I just think men should be easier to read. You know, like a home pregnancy test. We just pee on one, he sticks around, that's a boyfriend. seriously, sex should be like going to Disneyland. You know, you go for the afternoon with a friend. Just don't come home sick from the rides or with those mouse ears. I've had a lot of black guys asking me out lately, and this kind of worries me. Well, not because they're black, but I've just been wondering, maybe I've been letting myself go. I mean, like every other comic, I came to LA to get a big break in showbiz. I just don't know if I want mine to be on the Judge Mathis show, Sue and Tyrone for a $79 phone bill. So I have cats. I have three very beautiful Persian cats. These cats are awesome when they wake me up in the morning. My friend, Meow Mix, my friend. Awesome. They are so beautiful, they have such long, beautiful hair. Well, the girls do. The boy is bald, it's all in his back. I caught him behind the couch a couple weeks ago trying to glue a fur ball on his head. Probably would have worked too, except for the gold chain. I think he's turning into a terrorist, though. I came home a couple nights ago. He told me he was going to turn my microwave into a dirty bomb if I didn't give in to his demands. But these demands! He wanted a bottle of Cristal, two hot blondes, and a VIP booth at Sky Bar. So I come home tonight, he's got a pack of M80s strapped on. Oh, and a $1,000 Victoria's Secret bill. Good night, my name is Pauline. Oh, I forgot to tell you something. So I went to a Baptist church, and they like to pass the collection plate, you know? And something they don't usually see is a very large bill. So you can imagine my pastor the other day, when a $100 bill went by in the collection plate. Of course he had to make a big deal out of it, right? So he comes up to the stage, hey, we gotta praise the Lord here because there's a C note in the plate. Who put the C note in? And this poor gay gentleman in the back stands up. I did, it was all me. And so of course the church is now embarrassed, but they gotta give him something. So the pastor says, well, we'll let you pick out the next three hymns, okay? You can pick out the hymns and we'll sing whatever you choose. He was so excited. He stood there and went, I'll take him, and him, and him. Thank you all, my name is Pauline.
Pauline Williams, ladies and gentlemen, right there. Hey.